secret, we've been building a new football league. We've brought together some of the top football experts and some of the greatest players who have ever played the game with a commitment to put high-quality, top-flight football on the field. Today, we're going to announce an incredible television partner and a digital platform that will engage fans in a way that's never been done before. But I want to back up a little bit and talk about what we all know. America loves football. Now, we talk about that. There's been a lot of talk about the changes with the viewership and friends, but let's really break it down. Because if you look at the marketplace, about 1.5 million people watch your average professional baseball game. About 1.4 million watch basketball. About 300,000 watch your average hockey game, and about 140,000 watch your average soccer game. So let's put those numbers together and say that the other four major sports average about 3.5 million viewers a game, which by itself is an impressive number, until you consider the fact that you'd have to multiply that by six to get the average regular season professional football game. Now, what's hidden in that number is that millions of people are watching football and not watching other professional sports. So we talk about engagement. Now, in 2018, we know that engagement isn't just viewership on television. We have to look at other metrics. So let's look at fantasy. There are 59 million people in the United States who play some form of fantasy.
Yep.
20 million of them exclusively play football. So what do these mean together? It means that there are millions of Americans that from February, when football goes off the air, until August, when football comes back, millions of Americans stop watching all other sports. Millions of Americans stop playing fantasy. This is a massive gap in the market. This is a marketplace of tens of millions of Americans who have been telling us for decades that they want to see high-quality football longer than the football season. So it raises the question of, are there players? Well, there are 73,000 players that play in college in the United States, but there are only 1,700 jobs in professional football in the United States. That's less than 2% of available jobs for something that these guys love to do that they can't do in the U.S. So why is there only one league? Every other sport has multiple leagues. You want to play basketball? You can play basketball in multiple leagues in the U.S., let alone all over the world. Soccer, you can play high-quality professional soccer in multiple leagues in the U.S. and all over the world. Hockey, baseball, every other professional sport does it, but why not football? So I started that question, and I took it around. I went to journalists, I went to executives, I went to television personalities, I went to coaches and players and former players, people at the NCAA, people at the NFL, and started asking the question, why not? And I came back with one really basic answer. In the last quarter century, nobody has put real football by real football people on a field in the offseason. So how do you do that? We formed the Alliance of American Football to answer that question. It's based on a very simple idea. We call ourselves the Alliance because we're the alliance of three things. We're the alliance of the fans, we're the alliance of the players, or alliance of the game. Bringing those three things together ultimately was the most important thing, in our view, to putting quality football on the field.